Hello everyone, I'm Valentin from DM Trading Bulgaria. It's a beautiful Friday here in Sofia and I can't wait to go out with some friends to watch today's matches from the World Cup. But now let's do this recap video because the odds for the next week are very positive and then we all enjoy the weekend. First, I'm going to start with the trade that I posted last week on the metal palladium. You may remember that I've spoke for this support level that I've marked as a buy zone here. As you can see now, the price didn't stop exactly on the support as we were expecting. It's a little bit below it, but still it's in the borders because as you can see there was a break here and here. I was playing this trade very defensive because I didn't want to enter into the trade and to find myself into a situation like this where the prices continue falling to this support level here. So that's why I decided to wait, and this is the reason why there is still no live sign on this trade posted. Here, as we can observe, the price is consolidating a little bit below the buy zone, but for now, in my opinion, it's stable, and I'm waiting for a confirmation like a big green bar that it's going to close into the buy zone or maybe even above it. And then I'll post a signal and we'll open a position. Probably this will happen next week, at least I'm positive about this because as you know, now there is a lot of tension on the prices of the metals with the trade war begins between USA and China. But in my opinion, a big part from the drop is already done. So probably whenever the conditions on the markets are calm again, the prices of the metals will start to recover and hopefully we are going to observe nice movements on the long side and we will be able to extract good money from this. Maybe the palladium trade will be one of these, but we'll see how it's going to perform. Now for now the plan remains the same. As soon as the price gives us a confirmation that the trend is flipping and the price will start rise, we are going to open a long position and I'm going to post a live sign on about this in Twitter and we're going to hold it until at least until this level here. We'll check how the price is going to behave. If it's struggling to break it, probably we'll close 50 or even more percent here, or if it's going nice and steadily and it's still soaring and there is a lot of volume and there is power on the in the buyers and on the long side, we'll hold it till the target, which is somewhere around 1025 or maybe even 1030. The small target is settled somewhere around the 1000 mark, but in my opinion it will break it relatively easy as soon as the buying pressure is strong enough, and hopefully we'll be able to close this beloved profit during the next week. The next trade that I'm going to discuss with you is the one from Monday. It's again on the metal, it's on platinum this time. Here the setup is relatively close with that difference that the platinum is a little bit less liquid, so this is changing the game a little bit. As you can see, I've marked the buy zone again here for you that you may remember that this support level is the lowest point from 2016 up to now, and that's why I chose these borders for the buy zone. Probably I'm going to wait a little bit more and then I'll see if the price is going to confirm what you're expecting. As you know, the price was falling here, then it recovers. It made this huge green bar, I don't know if you can see it around here. I tweeted the live sign on this bar. We entered, I think it was around 835, I think it was a sign or something like this. Now the price is consolidating a little bit above the price, so we are a little bit in the money. And hopefully it will continue with the buying pressure in its source. It will break this buy zone here and will reach this level where we're going to make again a decision. We'll see if the buying pressure is strong enough. If it's not, we're going to close some of the percentage, some of the exposure here, or maybe even the whole position. We'll see about this. Or if the buying pressure is strong enough, we're going to hold it and We're going to wait until the price reaches the levels around here that are marked with these blue rectangles, and we're going to close the whole position a little bit above the 1000 mark, maybe around 1010. This was everything about this recap video. It was very short. The trades are looking good for now, and hopefully we'll be able to extract a good profit from them during the next week. Thank you very much for your attention. If you want to see more of these videos, you can always subscribe to our YouTube channel, or if you want to check some of the other materials that we are posting, you can follow us in our Facebook page, because all the articles and the news that we are posting are appearing there. And of course, I highly recommend to follow us in Twitter, because the live signals are appearing there, and it's very easy with them to open and close a trade and to realize good profit. Thank you very much for your attention again. I wish you a nice weekend and see you again next time. Bye bye.